see my screen. Alexander, is it okay?
Yes, perfect.
Okay. I'm starting again. Okay, so during this presentation, I will present you the trajectory we had these last years to provide the construction sector with rules how to build airtight in the Belgian construction sector. And for this, we had some research projects, and one of these was the Etanch’air project. In practice, what we see is that the way we are building airtight in Belgium is improving this last year. There are a lot of very good products on the market, but in practice, it's still the case that these products are not always very good installed on construction works. There are really a diversity of solutions, and you see there some examples that you should not apply in your building. What we see, in fact, is that architects have to deal with a large bunch of items when they are going for new construction. They have to select the airtight zone, they have to select their material, they have to install piping and ducts. They are also, of course, have to design the details and to provide this to the different persons, and they have to really take all these aspects into account from the very beginning of the conception, from the pre-project. So to really provide guidance to the sector, the Belgian Building Research Institute are produced recently a reference document, technical notes, decomposing in 10 steps the ways how to, which choice do you have to do to really build airtight and at the end to really have an airtight building. This document, you see there, technical notes, is available as well in French as in Dutch on our website if you are interested. So there are 10 steps you have to follow if you really want to build airtight. And the very first one is that you should define from the very beginning an ambition level. It's not the same to build a passive building as another building where you have a moderate ambition level. You have to know in Belgium that airtightness intake is taken into account in the energy performance calculation, but there is no explicit requirement in the regulation itself, so you could have requirements at the level of a specific building. You have a default value you can take into account in the calculation, so you are not obliged to make a pressurization test, but of course, if you build airtight, there is really a high interest to make this kind of test so that you can really show a better performance as the default value. So you should do a pressurization test at the end of the works, but if you really have an objective, an ambition level, you should know it from the very beginning. So it's really the step one. The next step when you are designing your building is that you also should know very early what is the airtight zone of the building, which zone do you want to make airtight, and it has of course also to do with the zone of the building that will be insulated. It's what we are calling in Belgium the protected volume. So you really have to be able to show that on the plan of your building so that you know from the very beginning which part of the building you want to insulate and to make airtight. There are also some elements, some contradiction you can have when you build a building between requirement of ventilation of specific installation or room and the airtightness requirements. We took here an example of a boiler, and if you install this kind of boiler in a building, we know in Belgium that you really have to install permanent opening in this room. In fact, it's in contradiction with the airtightness ambition you could have for this building. But actually, it's really a choice you are making at the conception level you choose for this boiler. So a possibility could be that you take into account the fact that there will be a permanent opening, or another possibility could be that you select another boiler to avoid this kind of contradiction. we have made in Belgium a complete inventory of all contradictions we found between requirements for ventilation of specific room or installation and the airtightness requirement, and we really have their guidance for all the room or all installation, for instance, for garage, technical shafts, elevator shafts, and so on. The fourth step, when you have, you know, your airtightness zone, is that you probably have to force in some piping and ducts, and there will be passage of ducts through the airtightness envelope. And there are some bad examples, but you also see there two good examples how to, you can foresee this passage of ducts through the airtightness envelope, and it's really possible to have a good solution there. Of course, it requires some place in the building, and you see there, for instance, an example of technical shaft where the place was not enough to make it airtight. It's really very common in Belgium to see this kind of situation, but actually you should really try to have enough space to be able to install all the necessary system in your building. Next element, of course, is that you have also to have good material to provide or to achieve an airtight envelope. What you see here, it's the result of laboratory tests on construction material, where we are measuring the airtightness performance of different material. So we are building some walls, in this case, concrete walls, and we are making, we are creating an airtightness pressure difference through this wall to be able to measure an air leakage. During this test, we have added some water with soap on the wall, and where you see bubbles, it means that there are air going through the wall, creating the bubble. So the first picture is a concrete wall, the second one is a concrete wall with painting, and the third one is a concrete wall with a plaster layer. And it's really possible, based on these tests, to measure the airtightness performance of different material, and based on that, also to give guidance to the construction sector. Actually, we are considering that a material is airtight if its permeability is below 0.1 cubic meter per square meter for pressure difference of 50 Pascal. It's a material of a combination of material. On the third picture, for instance, it's concrete wall with a plaster layer, and this is indeed below this limit of 0.1. The sixth step when you are making a construction work is that you have to choose your doors and windows, which is also a very important element in the conception process. You know that these components are tested in laboratory. For the moment, in the European standards, there are four classes existing. The class one is the less airtight one. The class four is the most airtight one. But you see also there that the area of class four is very wide. You find back this information in the CE marking available when you are buying a new door or window, and you see there that the performance of air permeability can be found on this CE marking. If you really want to have a very airtight building, our advice in Belgium is that you should ask for the test report really to know the performance of your doors and windows and to know if it's a good class four door or a basic performance for the class four. No, actually, in the building there are a lot of construction details you have to realize. And one of the questions was is there a priority in the construction details we have to do in the building, or are all construction details as important? And to answer this question, we had during the Etanch’air project a lot of measurements made in situ in buildings, really to measure the air leakage. You see here an example of air leakage we made on the window, but we did that on a lot of construction details. And based on these tests, it has been possible to make a summary, you see there, with priority for the different construction details. Priority one is the most important one, with the highest priority. In general, it's all the details with light construction, for instance, pitch roof. All connection with pitch roof, it's 3 or 4 star with the highest priority. And then the lowest priority is with only 1 star. It's, for instance, the junction between separating wall and facade. It's really up to the architect to decide which nodes have to be really built with high precision and very high airtightness, and it's in correlation with the ambition 11. It's possible if you are building a passive building that all details are very important as well, the priority 4. But if you have an average ambition level there, maybe if you are selecting very good data for the priority 1 and 2, it could be enough to reach this average ambition level. So we have their guidance, which are the really the priority details to be selected and treated on site. And how to build airtight, in the reference document we show, we have provided about 60 details everywhere in the detail as well, massive construction as light construction, so with wood. And you can really select there the typical details that you can adapt for your construction work. You see there example of details available. And these details are actually good for all building contractors as well as those building the masonry, as those installing the plaster and so on. So we have really had a lot of discussion to come to details acceptable for all building contractors. There are still 2 steps in the process. When you are building a building, there are a lot of coordination and communication necessary between all the builders, the building contractors, and we have there checklists for the architect, for instance, but also for the building contractors. Which point do they have to take into account when they are building airtight? And the very last step, when you are building your building, actually, is that you could also consider the fact that an intermediate pressurization test could be useful. Certainly, when you want to have passive building and that the building contractor does not have too much experience, it's really a good advice to do a pressurization test during the construction work when the airtightness barrier is still accessible, so that it's still possible to improve it and then to come to an acceptable result at the end of the construction work, certainly if there are requirements for this building. Okay, that was it. I thank you for your attention.